Hi, this is Scot Pekarek with Verde Real Estate Group with today's real estate tip. With us today, we are joined by Chris George from Attorneys Title Group LLC. How are you doing, Chris?
I'm good, Scot. How about you?
I'm doing awesome. So we've got kind of a tricky topic today, which is some of the nuances that exist when buying into a homeowners association, townhouse, condo, co-op, you know, generally referred to as a common interest community.
Sure.
And some things to look out for. Some are title issues and some go beyond title, but we're gonna pick Chris's brain and have him tell us things he looks for and things he thinks you should be aware of.
Sure. So when you're a buyer, especially if it's part of a common interest community, I believe the association is required to provide documents to you, and you have a 10-day review period.
10-day right of rescission, yeah. Correct.
So you have a chance to review these documents, and you care about that because as a buyer, you want to understand what rules, restrictions, covenants, conditions, easements, all those things exist in your association and what that means you can and cannot do with the property that you're buying. It's not going to be obvious at the outset what those things are. You have to probably drill down and actually read those docs a little bit to figure out what let's say you want to put a pool in.
Right.
You want to make sure that you know you're not violate whatever setback restrictions they have or whether they even allow pools.
Right. And we're not limited to a condo or a townhouse. This could be single family home.
Absolutely.
Associations. I live in a single family home that happens to be an association.
Exactly.
And there are restrictions to what I can do.
We did the home we owned before the one we're in now was a part of a master association, and one day we were like, you know, let's paint our front door. I'm like, okay, so we painted it. About a week later, got a letter from the association saying, hey, you know, you can't do that unless you run it through the Architectural Control Committee. And I'm like, well, this is...
Chris lives in Stepford,
yeah,
Massachusetts.
Right. And so it's one of those things where some of these, they do this because they want to preserve the integrity, the aesthetic integrity of the community and keep those values up. So they don't want you painting your door a weird color or polka dots or whatever.
And we've all heard the story of the World War II veteran that put the flagpole in his front yard and flew the flag and all hell broke loose, right?
Yeah, and so you've just got to be... You know, you have to understand what rules and requirements your association has. Now, the only way to know that is to look at the docs. You probably could also ask whoever the management company is for the association. They should know. So during that 10-day period, you could use your due diligence and try to learn that information.
Yeah, and I always say don't believe everything that's on the MLS. Don't
right.
believe everything someone tells you. You have to see it in print,
yep.
in official documents.
Yep.
Ask for the board minutes. Make sure that
right.
there isn't some surprise that's coming down
well,
the pipe.
They have restrictions on pets sometimes.
Right.
Or on renting, if you ever wanted to rent it. Or
well, Airbnb,
like
VRBO right now, huge with the vacation
like property.
Yeah.
They don't want you to do nightly rentals.
Yeah.
And so, and 10 years ago when the market went down, so many people were renting because they couldn't sell.
Right.
That then associations responded by saying, well, we got to cap the rental percentage at a certain number because we don't want this entire association overrun with rental property. That's not what we wanted this to be.
Right.
So
right.
it's important to review those documents, you know, before closing so then you're not surprised when you buy because there's no return policy on that.
What about from a closing agent or title agent, title company's perspective, is there certain documents you need to see?
So typically anything of record. You know,
okay.
So when I say of record, I mean recorded with the real estate records in the county in which the property is located. Typically, whatever establishes the association is called a declaration, and that kind of sets forth the association and incorporates the property into that association and then subjects it to all those restrictions and rules. And so we have copies of all that stuff too. Now, we don't get too into the weeds on whether or not you can put a fence up or, you know, put a camper in your driveway.
Right.
You know, because those things aren't really title issues. Those are more use and enjoyment issues. But, you know, if somebody really did have concerns, we certainly could at least, you know, provide copies, which they probably already have, but if they wanted more clarification, we certainly
right.
could help them with that. But yeah, so we look for those documents to be of record because to me, your property is not really subject to an association until it's of record with the county, so
right.
everybody knows it's part of that association. So,
and then prior to closing, you're going to require what's called a due current letter
yeah,
to make sure.
Documents. You do one. You do the resale disclosure.
Correct.
Right, and the resale disclosure is pretty much like the big brother or big sister of the due current letter because it tells the prospective buyer, the financial health of the association, what the monthly dues are the dues current, are there any fees for buying, things like that. And then the dues current letter just essentially restates that information just at a closer date to the closing. We want to make sure that the dues are paid current because the buyer doesn't want to be subject to delinquent association dues.
Right.
And because we're
right.
likely providing owner's title insurance, that would be our responsibility then, which we don't want. So. That's what that dues current letter does. It does a couple of things. It tells us that the dues are paid current, usually through the month that we're closing, and also that there might not be any pending assessments that are on the horizon. usually with big condos like in the city, sometimes that comes up. And it could be a big dollar amount.
Yeah, especially with water intrusion, balcony work, and stuff like that.
You know, and then who pays for it?
You mean, right.
Ideally, you know, the buyer would want the seller to do it, but maybe the seller wasn't aware of it. Well, then what happens? Well, you don't want to close and then have it be an issue after closing. You want to make sure that's dealt with before the closing, so everybody's on the ball. And so that's what the Deuce Current Letter kind of does.
Well, things get even more complicated too in the event of a foreclosure, because then who's, you know, is the lender responsible for how many months of the dues?
You know, the association thinks they should pay everything.
Right.
But then they might, I think that there might be a statute, and I would need to bone up on this. I think
six months.
Yeah. And so that's usually what you're kind of maxed out at. And then hopefully the management company kind of corroborate that at the closing. But we as the title company really do want to make sure that the buyer is taking subject to the property and paying only the dues that they owe, and not anything that's outstanding.
Right.
So that's what the Deuce Current Letter will tell us. So
awesome. Wow. It's always more complicated than you think.
Indeed.
So Chris, if someone wants to learn more about this or any other topic, how do they get a hold of you?
Sure, they can call me. My number is 651-338-6632, or email is also a good option. My email address is cgeorge@attorneystitlemn.com.
Awesome. Thanks so much, Chris.
You're welcome, Scott.
So I'm Scott Pekarek with Verde Real Estate Group. Like always, if you want to get a hold of us and get more information on this topic or any other topic, our number is 612-600-8888, 612-600-8888. Call or text or 24/7 online at verde-realestate.com. We hope this content has been valuable. Like always, if you need further assistance, please reach out to us. Thank you.